When I walk into the store, I see this nice, beautiful pile of Technicolor t-shirts, baby! We've got Gildan and Fruit of the Loom. Now, what I'm doing is buying XXL for two main reasons. Reason numero uno, I wear that size, so if I don't sell these, on the off chance that, you know, the e-commerce gods frown on me, I can keep them. And also because the larger sizes generally sell a lot better than the smaller sizes. Blame it on obesity. Blame it on fashion sense. I don't know. It is a fact, though. Bigger sizes sell better. I got the Gildan t-shirts. I could not find Fruit of the Loom in 2XL. I got all the same size. I will lot these up, sell them for 30 bucks, and ship them in a priority padded mailer. I go to a few Dollar Trees. I haven't seen t-shirts at all of them, but check when you're there. Usually they're right by the front.
When you're selling an in-demand product like t-shirts that has a lot of competition, one of the best ways to ensure you're making money is by knowing how you're gonna ship it. If you're shipping one t-shirt, it might be $3, $4, $5, $6 to ship that on eBay. That's a lot of money for a single t-shirt. However, by utilizing things like this right here, a USPS flat rate padded mailer, you can stuff 8 to 10 t-shirts in that bad boy. Roll them up like little cotton sushi rolls, stick them in here, and suddenly you go from paying $4 or $5 per t-shirt to one, maybe 80 cents per t-shirt.
It's only early August here, but fall stuff is out at our Dollar Trees. This fall decor, pumpkins, shiny pumpkins, matte pumpkins, glazed owls. All of this stuff is going to sell. I'm seeing it on other YouTube accounts that don't focus on resell stuff, that focus on like style and decoration. So if they're recommending it, certainly I'll be buying it because they are the tastemakers. I only follow their lead. I like these. They look cool. They look sturdy. I am worried about them chipping. So when I ship these, what I'll do is put them with foam around them. I have this new foam cloth type stuff. I'll show you in a minute. I bought it for moving, but it works great for delicates just like this. It's pretty obvious to everyone. I've been on a Hot Wheels kick. I don't know why. I'm not a car guy. I just like how they look. I like the market. It's fun to search these out. And I heard a tip from one of you listeners, one of you viewers, that the white packaging Hot Wheels at Dollar Tree, those are hot, 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 hot. And here's one right here, Hot Wheels ID. The Hot Wheels ID. Scan me, I'm one of a kind. The Porsche Taycan Turbo. You know, again, I'm not a car guy, but I am an e-commerce guy. I am an eBay guy. And these are selling for 15 or 20 bucks on eBay. $1 into $20 is never a bad flip. There's also the Tesla Supercar Hot Wheels. If you can find those are also a good flip. Couldn't find them, but what I did see snuck down here in the corner in this pile of toys, the detritus of the dollar store, is a Unified Minds Pokemon card pack. Spoiler alert, I didn't find any, but would you guys like to see a sports cards or a Pokemon card hunting Dollar Tree video? Let me know. Okay, so it's empty. Someone stole these cards. Oh, so annoying. But maybe I can find some more, because if I can find more of those Pokemon cards, that would be a great flip. I'm in Ann Arbor. A lot of you guys know that. That is not where Michigan State is. Michigan State is like an hour and a half away. They are rival schools. That's why things are still here. I have a good feeling about these. No comps. It's only August. But once tailgate season comes around, I feel good about selling these for like 10 bucks for the two-pack. Very light. Will ship for like $3 or $4. Easy profit there. And also, you're going to learn the ropes. A lot of the stuff like this Family Feud, these little games here. Again, they're not huge profit makers. But if you're new and you want to turn $1 into $4 or $5, you want to learn the ropes of e-commerce, of eBay, of Amazon. I cannot think of a better way. That's why I make these videos for you guys. Back over to the fall decorations. So this stuff right here, the issue you're going to run into if you try and sell it online is shipping. Could you make local sales with bundles of cool fall Dollar Tree decorations? Yeah, of course you could. Thanksgiving stuff, Halloween stuff. It's not heavy, but it is big, and it's kind of difficult to ship. Some of the stuff might be easy to ship. I'm not saying it's all hard to ship. Like over here, this easy to ship in a poly mailer. some of the other stuff kind of folds together and will ship easily. I'm not saying that this is the kind of stuff you want to sell individually, but if you have a lot of four or five items, maybe it's dorm room decoration, I don't know, that could be a great way to sell it. And on a side note, these pickles, I bought two of them. They cost $2.50 at Kroger. Do you guys buy snacks from Dollar Tree? I'm curious. Let me know in the comments below what your favorite Dollar Tree snack is. Over to our bread and butter items, health and beauty. These liquid skin half gram sticks, these are moving on eBay. They're great. You know, it's a great product. And whenever you have a great product that you use, your family uses, it's always worth looking up. I'm getting four of these, but you could sell them as much as like 10 or 15 because they are so light. If you've watched my previous Dollar Tree videos, you know that I bought these charcoal toothpaste boxes that's Brush Buddies. They actually sold for $10 for me in about 2 weeks, maybe less than that, maybe even a week. Two pack, $10, $2 to buy them, about $3.50 to ship. Not a huge money maker, but again, if you want to learn the ropes, do it this way. We've seen this next product featured so much in my videos, I feel like Chester is stalking me. The Cheetos Mac and Cheese. Bold and cheesy, jalapeno cheese, and then over here on the left, Flamin' Hot. I bought the Flamin' Hot ones because those were worth the most. The mac and cheese, bold and cheesy flavor, about a dollar profit, but these, Flamin' Hot, much more profitable. I'm gonna sell these on Amazon, and if you look at my phone right here, based on the lowest Amazon price, if we buy them for a dollar and we sell them Amazon FBA, we're gonna be making over $3 profit after fees, after shipping, per box. And later on in the video, I will explain to you in painful detail how to get ungated in grocery. It's not hard, it really is quite simple, and there are so many people out there trying to take advantage of you, trying to sell you $2,000 courses or $500 consulting fees, and really, you know, pardon my French, it's bullshit. All you have to do is buy from a verified distributor, and guess what? I know one, and I have a discount code for you. So stick around, because in a few minutes, we're gonna go over this and we're gonna talk about how to get ungated in grocery using legitimate invoices and not these, oh God, I can't even say it. Just these disgusting tactics that these other jerks use to rip you off for what really is free information if you watch my YouTube channel. But enough about that. These are poppets. If you buy shapes like dinosaurs or unicorns or octopuses, the going rate on eBay is like $5 to $8. Whoa, really great haul, bought some good stuff. Let's go back to my warehouse now and go through it. Okay, we are back in the warehouse, and I know, I got a haircut. It is insane that people cut their hair. So we're gonna talk about a few things that I bought that I think you can learn a lot from. The first thing is gonna be this little metallic pumpkin right here. So most people would say bubble wrap is the way to go. And if you have big half inch bubble wrap, yeah, absolutely. But the small eighth of an inch bubble wrap, that stuff is gonna pop and you're gonna still chip it. What I use for that is right here. Foam sheets. Like, I called it foam cloth. I don't know why. It's foam sheets. I got these when I was moving all of my plates, and it really does work great for making sure that these shiny metallic surfaces don't get dinged up. Now again, I didn't see any comps on these because they're brand new, but when I see YouTube channels with hundreds of thousands of viewers saying, oh yeah, these are so great, you gotta buy them, of course I'm gonna recommend to you guys to buy them, to sell them. In my Dollar Tree, I'm already seeing them off the shelves, so quick hurry, if you see them, buy them. I am very, very confident that these will go for at least $5 plus shipping per. The next thing I wanna talk about is this, the Cheetos Flamin' Hot Mac and Cheese box. So how are we gonna ship those? You could lot them up on eBay and sell them in a lot of like 6 or 10 and make decent money. But what I think the best thing to do is to use Amazon FBA. That stands for Fulfilled by Amazon. Now, if you've been doing this for a minute, you're gonna say, wait, Amazon FBA, grocery items, I'm gated in that. But don't worry, friends, I have a solution to your problems. So there are so many people out there gurus, jackasses, jerks who want to charge you $2,000 for their grocery and gating course or $500 for their consulting fee. That's bullshit. They're not your friends. They want to take advantage of you. I'm going to tell you right now, all you have to do is find a verified distributor, someone who Amazon knows sells authentic products. And who does that? Is it hard to find? Do people like me charge for the info? Well, people like me do. Me personally don't. I personally don't. Who I recommend is katytexaswholesale.com. You can go to the website, scroll through all their grocery items, buy 10 units of Goya beans. You go to Amazon, you go to list those beans. They ask for invoices. You supply the invoices, and suddenly you're selling groceries on Amazon. There are so many people in the reselling world who treat this info like it's some sort of magic spell or a secret code that it becomes kind of like, oh, I don't know if I can do this. No, you can do this. It's not weird. It's not a hack. It's just doing legitimate business. And when you do that, use the code WBK10. It's an affiliate code. I get some money, you get 10% off, and you're not gonna spend like $500. You could literally spend as little as like $60 and you could sell those products. It isn't money down the drain, it's money you're investing in your business. You're gonna recoup a lot of that, probably even profit. I don't know, it depends how patient you are. And suddenly, the whole world of grocery retail arbitrage has been opened up to you. You can go to Kroger, you can go to Safeway, you can go to Costco, you can go to Walmart, you can go to all these grocery stores and find items people want. You can make money that way. You can go to distributors, other ones, I don't care. You can go to manufacturers and buy direct from them. Suddenly, your side hustle might be your main hustle. If you like info like this, please, I encourage you to give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe and comment below with what excites you about making money. I want to help you make more money online. I've done lots of stuff. I have no qualms about sharing my info. I just need to know what you want to hear. I'll see you guys later, probably next week.